All right, we are the Israelites. Come out every week on some corner to teach our people where they are. Also, we come to let you know who you are according to the Bible, which you're Edomites. Come to let you know the judgment that the Most High has placed upon this place, which is death and destruction, man. All right? Even though you go in your churches, the Most High is still going to judge you for the things that you've done in the past. Going back to slavery, going back to the stealing and the robbing of this land, and all the other lands in the earth and the natural resources that you have taken from the children of Israel and the rest of the world. All right, to the so-called white man. All right, so go ahead.
This is Isaiah 14 and 4. That thou shalt take up this proverb against the king of Babylon.
Nah, I don't want that one.
Isaiah 12 verse 1. In that day thou shalt say, O Lord, I will praise thee, though thou was angry with me, thine anger is turned away, and thou comforts me. Isaiah 13 and 1. The burden of Babylon, which Isaiah the son of Amos did see. Lift ye up a banner upon the high mountain.
Right, what's that banner? That banner is these words, it's Bible. Alright, and the true breaking down of it. Now how they do up in these churches. Alright, what's that high mountain? That high mountain is America. You read the book of Revelations, mountains are symbolic for kingdoms. Alright, so it says, raise ye the banner upon the high mountain. What does that mean? It means raise up this word on America. This is Babylon in the Bible. Go ahead.
Exalt the voice unto them, shake the hand, that they may go into the gates of the noble.
Exalt the voice. What does that mean? Raise up the voice. Why we not using bullhorn? That they may go into the gates of the noble. That's where we at. The gates of the noble. Downtown Orlando. Big churches down here where all the high up people in Orlando go to church at. Go ahead.
I have commanded my sanctified ones. I have also called my mighty ones for mine anger.
I've commanded my sanctified ones. Who is that? Going into the angels, but not just the angels. Going into the prophets of Yasharala, Israel. You have commanded his sanctified ones to go out and do what? To go out and teach his word. Against these mountains. All right, go ahead.
This is Jeremiah 51. I don't know if he had it already. 51 and 25. It says, behold, I am against thee, O destroying mountain.
Right, there you go again. What's that mountain? Mountains are represented, or mountains are symbolic for kingdoms. So the Lord said he is against thee, O destroying mountain.
Yeah.
Now what has America done all over the world? Destroyed.
Yeah.
Look at Iraq. That place is destroyed. Look at the land that we're in now. It's destroyed and polluted. So the Most High God said, I am against the old destroying mountain. And he's against this place called America.
Right.
Go ahead.
Which destroyeth all the earth. Which destroyeth all the earth.
Which destroyeth all the earth. How would you destroy all the earth?
You gotta be America, man.
You went through the earth conquering and subjecting nations to your will. Destroying a different nation through war and violence. What else? You went through the earth destroying through your pollution. What else? You went through the earth destroying through your ways of life.
Doctrine,
your doctrines. Like Christianity, which goes back to Egypt, which goes back to Babylon, which goes back to the antediluvian world, which goes back to that fruit that Adam ate. Or Eve and Eve ate. Go ahead.
And it says, which destroyeth all the earth, and I will stretch out my hand upon thee and roll thee down from the rocks.
Right. Which
And we'll make thee a burnt mountain.
Right, and we'll make thee a burnt mountain. Mean what? This place is going to be destroyed by thermonuclear fire.
Right.
According to the Most High God. All right? Go ahead, go back.
I have commanded my sanctified ones. I have also called my mighty ones for mine anger, even them that rejoice in my highness. The noise of a multitude in the mountains, like as of a great people, a tumultuous noise of the kingdom, of nations gathered together. The Lord of hosts mustereth the host of the battle. They come from a far country, from the end of heaven, even the Lord and the weapons of his indignation, to destroy the whole land.
That's right. That's why in the Middle East, the Most High is gathering all those countries over there together to fight a war over there, that they may destroy this kingdom. All right, the Most High God is about to destroy this kingdom called America. It ain't gonna be no new American century. The Most High is about to judge you. Go ahead.
How ye, for the day of the Lord is at hand. It shall come as a destruction from the Almighty. Therefore shall all hands be faint, and every man's heart shall melt.
Mm-hmm.
And they shall be afraid. Pangs and sorrows shall take hold of them. They shall be in pain as a woman that travaileth. They shall be amazed one at another. Their faces shall be as flames. Behold, the day of the Lord cometh cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger, to lay the land desolate, and he shall destroy the sinners thereof out of it. For the stars of heaven and the constellations therefore shall not give their light. The sun shall be darkened in his going forth.
Give me Revelation chapter 11, verse 18. That's good with that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Revelation chapter 11, verse 18. And the nations were angry, and thy wrath is come, and the time of the dead, that they should be judged, that thou shouldest give reward unto thy servants, the prophets.
Read that again.
And the nations were angry, and thy wrath is come.
And right, and the nations were angry, and thy wrath is come. Man, what? These nations are angry with you, with America. You went through all throughout the earth spreading your wicked doctrine, your Christianity, your fake version of Christianity, which is not according to the Bible. You went throughout the earth spreading your democracy, which is really not freedom at all. Really, it's tyranny. You went throughout the earth spreading all of that stuff. Now the nations are angry with you, ready to destroy you, because it's the judgment of the Most High God. Hey, give me Revelation. Hold that. All right, hold that. Give me Revelation chapter 13, verse, start at verse 9.
It's Revelation 13, verse 9.
Wait, nope. Start at verse 6.
Verse 6. And he opened his mouth in blasphemy against the Most High to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle and them that dwelt in heaven.
Right, like you got this fake image, this false image, and you say this is Jesus Christ. When nobody in the Middle East even looked like that. There was no white man named Jesus Christ. Stand on that shit, man. That's dumb shit. There was no white man in the Middle East named Jesus Christ, man. That's a false image. That's blasphemy, man, that they got it from these churches. Go ahead.
And it was given unto him to make war with the saints and to overcome them, and power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations.
Who are the saints? The children of Israel. Who are the children of Israel? They're not them people over there in Israel now. Those are just regular old Edomites, just like you. Regular old Edomites, wicked and just like you. The Israelites are the saints. The saints are the people of Israel, which are the Negroes, Native Americans, and Hispanics that you brought over in slavery. Those are the saints. So it said, what do you do to the saints?
Make war with them.
You made war with the saints, and that war is still going on. plague all these damn abortion clinics in our communities, alcohol damn stores, all right? Drugs in our communities, you put that shit there. You put it there for us. You got us hooked on these things. You programmed our people to love them things and to love your ways. Because you fought a war against us. Now you're gonna walk to your churches and hold your Bibles clenched in your hand like you're holy. When you perpetuated all this wickedness throughout the earth. Now we're gonna use the same Bible to condemn you and rebuke you and let you know the Most High about to judge this place. And the Most High about to bring judgment on America, which is Babylon the Great, according to the Bible. Go ahead.
And all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him.
Yeah, everybody on the earth worshiping you.
Right.
American culture has dominated the whole entire earth because every nation worships you. That ain't talking about you, or it's talking about the Roman Catholic Church, right? It's not talking about the Roman Catholic Church. It's talking about the so-called white man in America. Now all the other nations worshiping after you. They want to be American. They're in their own country speaking English, losing their own heritage. Go ahead.
And all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him.
Right.
Whose names are not written in the book of life.
Right.
Of the Lamb.
Right.
Slain from the foundation of the world.
Mm-hmm.
If any man have an ear, let him hear.
Right.
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
Oh, okay. This is talking about the Roman Catholic Church, right? Did not America, the so-called white man, lead it to captivity? Captivity is slavery.
Right.
Hey, not only did you lead the so-called Negroes into captivity and the Native Americans, you done led the animals into captivity for your pleasure. So you think the Most High not going to judge you and pay you back for that? Because you clenched that Bible real tight and you walk up in the church like it's yours and don't follow nothing in it? Nah, the Most High going to judge you. You're not getting away with that judgment, man. Most I say he's by his name he gonna judge you, man. Go ahead.
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword.
We went throughout the earth with the sword, killing and conquering. The sword today is the gun. Who goes in every country and fight, take their country with a gun? Is it not the United States military? Who's looking to go into Iran right now as we speak? Who can't stay in their own country? They have to go to other people's country and tell them what to do, or if you don't follow what America does, we're coming in with the sword or with the gun with our military. So is not the Most High going to judge this place? Yeah, he's going to judge it. He's going to judge it. America's not going to escape judgment. No other country has. And America's not going to be the first. Go ahead.
Here is the patience and the faith of the saints.
That's why we patient. We come out every week. We come teach this word with patience because we know these things are going to happen. Go ahead.
And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon.
Wait, he had two horns as a lamb. Why is it liking this beast as a lamb? Because a lamb is docile, sweet, it's not a predator. That's how American so-called white men come up. Oh, well, we're nice, we're docile, we'll help you. We just want to help you. We want to help your country. But really, they're trying to take over your country. Trying to take your natural resources. Oh, no. We come with the Bible. We come to save you. We have to go throughout the earth, 1492. We got to go throughout the earth, and we got to baptize all the nations and save them. But what did you do when you got here? You pushed the Bible down their throat, you pushed this white image down their throat, and then you whipped them, you beat them, you burned them, and you killed them. But that was your way of salvation. So that's why Allah, it says that this beast was as a lamb. Meaning he came as he was like, as a lamb, docile and sweet. Not a predator, but it said he had two horns. Your two horns represent what? Your two forms of, your two parties of government. your democracy, your Democrats and your Republicans, your two supposedly opposing parties, which are not truly opposite or opposing at all.
Right.
It's just set up as an illusion. And you went throughout the whole earth talking about some democracy. Democracy. Two opposing parties. Democracy. But really in the end it's all wickedness. Go ahead.
And he exercises all the power of the first beast before him and causes the earth and them with love on it to worship the first beast.
What's that first beast? That first beast is Rome. You got everybody worshiping Rome. Everybody thinks we are using Roman numerals. The letters are in Roman styles. The alphabet damn near come from the Roman alphabet. Your buildings, look at this church. This shit has Roman columns on it. See that church over there? Four Roman columns on it. That goes back to Rome.
Yeah, that's Rome shit.
That's Roman. And we went to this church right here, where we standing in front of this big-ass church right here. They got some big, big Roman
It's on the other side.
Yeah, it's in front of the church. Got some big Roman,
It's a whole block, right?
Things.
It's a whole block?
It's a whole block. They got a whole block of church, man. On stolen ground. All right? Remind you that all of this, the big ass, and that shit come from Egypt. That's the phallus symbol. That's the fucking phallus on top.
Yeah.
Goes back to what they call, I can't think of the name.
On Church Street.
Right, we on church. Go ahead. Go with your precept, bro.
This is Psalms 50 verse 16. But unto the wicked, God said, who has thou to do to declare my statutes, or that thou shouldst take up my covenant in thy mouth?
Right, you know, you walk around here like you holy, man. Looking at us like something, like what are these guys doing? The 12 tribes of Israel, you walk around here with your Bible clenched, they walk around here like this.
Yeah.
Like this shit make them holy.
They always do that.
Because they got to clench the Bible real tight.
Right.
But then they go into church and they come out. Yeah. Next thing you know, they go in to eat on breakfast, and it's a bunch of pork on the plate.
Yeah,
that don't make you holy. So the Most High say, what has you to do to declare my statutes?
Right.
Meaning you up in the church with this Bible trying to teach people. Trying to tell them that they sinning. Don't even tell them what the sin is.
Right.
That's what they love to do. Tell people they sinning, but don't even know what this, they even telling them what sin is.
Telling them they sinning, and then at the same time telling them that the laws are done away with. That doesn't
exactly
even make sense.
Exactly.
That's a blatant hypocritical lie right there, man. Contradiction.
The law's done away with, but you can't do it. You can't commit adultery, which according to them is sleeping with multiple women.
Right.
I thought the laws were done away with. So that's why the Most High said, where is thou to declare my statutes?
Right.
That thou shouldest take it my covenant and thy mouth. Meaning if this covenant ain't got nothing to do with no damn American or no Edomite or no heathen. These law, statutes, and commandments, the Savior, and everything contained in the Bible has only to do with Yahshua. Why it says judgment is of Israel, man. Judgment pertaining to Israel.
Right.
But you walk around here with your Bible clenched like this, like that shit gonna save you. Like this gonna make you holy, and the Most High gonna forget about all the wickedness that y'all done perpetuated and still are perpetuating in the earth. Yeah, you done?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead. Yeah, I need that precept.
We just heard it.
Whatever you have precept for, it don't even matter. Whatever y'all want to bring out.
What you want to finish on
Isaiah? Alright, yeah, go ahead, Isaiah. Yeah.
That's some good shit.
Go ahead, yeah.
I need to start where we stopped.
Yeah, Isaiah, yeah.
Isaiah 13.
Wait, matter of fact, wait. Finish reading that in Revelation. We're going to come back to this. I want to get this part with two horns and shit. Go ahead.
Verse 12. And he exerciseth all the power of the first beast before him, and causeth the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast.
What was that first beast? It was the Roman Empire.
Right.
What power and dominion did the Roman Empire have? They dominated and ruled the whole known earth at that time. They dominated and ruled the whole known earth. Every people that was known, they ruled them at that time. So what does it mean he exercised the power of the first beast? America and the so-called white man rules all the nations of the earth. They do it through the United Nations and their secret councils. Okay? Go ahead.
To worship the first beast whose deadly wound was healed.
Right? That's why people are basically in the Roman culture. American culture is based off of Roman culture. Go ahead.
And he doeth great wonders so that he make a fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men.
Go ahead.
And deceived them that dwell on the earth.
Right, hold on. He did great wonders that he made fire come down out the sky on the earth in the sight of men. Who did that shit? Was it the Africans? No, it was a so-called white man in America.
Right.
When they dropped that damn atomic bomb on Nagasaki, Hiroshima. And the shit blew up and fire came out the sky. They say we don't want to fuck with America no more. Oh yeah, the Roman Catholic Church did that shit too, huh? Nah, Babylon the Great is America. Go ahead.
And deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast.
Oh, right.
He said.
Right.
Hold it up. That's what he said. 2 Thessalonians 2:9-8. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming.
Yep.
Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders.
Right.
And with all deceivableness of unrighteous in them that perish.
That's right, man, that this so-called white man is to see the whole earth by his science.
Yeah.
By his miracles. People think miracles are something, some act by the Most High God. A miracle is something that you can't understand. Mm-hmm. That's just not understandable because you don't have the knowledge to understand it.
Right.
The knowledge is not readily available. So that's what this man did, false miracles. He used his science to deceive you. Make you think that he's God, he's a God, he's the people of God. Look how great he is.
Right.
And he deceived the whole earth. Go ahead, all right, go ahead. It's going to get nice.
And with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth.
The truth. That they ain't love the truth. The truth, we talking the truth.
Yeah.
Now, 90% of the people on this earth I'm not going to receive the truth. I say 99%. 99.8% of the people on the earth don't love the truth. They hate the truth. We're telling the truth. We're speaking the truth. All you got to do is look up the records for this so-called white man in America. Read their history. Their real history.
Yeah.
Not the shit they teach you in the schools. That's the made-up nice stuff. Yeah. Read their real history. Go read what they was doing in Europe. Read what how they settled America. And then you'll understand what we're saying is true. Go ahead, I got more than that.
Yep. It says, because they received not the love of the truth that they might be saved.
Right.
And for this cause, God shall
this shit right here.
God shall send them strong delusion.
That's why these churches on every corner.
Yeah.
And then Negroes, they get caught up and they go right in these damn churches. Because it's big and it's pretty.
Right.
Because the pastor, he's white, he got the nice garment on, he speaks. Welcome everybody to the church of this shit, this bullshit. And today we're going to talk about love. And you have to love your neighbor and you have to love everybody because we love everybody. We fucking destroyed them, but we love them. So that's why these churches set up. The Most High let these churches be set up. Jake going there and get deceived. Because they ain't love the truth, man. Right. They ain't love these words, what we saying, man. So the Most High let them get deceived by the deceiver, so-called white man.
You know a nigga is deceived when he's in a damn nigga's in Mormonism, sure, man.
Hell yeah.
When you see a nigga in Mormonism, in the Mormon church, you know he's fucked, man. That's a nigga that's deceived. When it blatantly tells you in their Mormon Bible that being black is a curse, man. It's a curse, man. You lost well, I guess you gained melanin, which is a curse now. It doesn't make any fucking sense, man. So those are motherfuckers that's deceived, man.
This is Psalms 55 verse 21. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, for war was in his heart. His words were softer than oil, yet were they drawn swords.
Said his words in his mouth were smoother than butter, man. Why did they reference it as with butter? Butter is real slick, man. Real slick, greasy, and loose, you know, it's slippery, you know, you put it in the pan, you put it on bread or whatever, you slide it, glide it on, it says it's smoother than butter, so basically he's not going to come at you all rough, you know, and austere like we do, man.
Abrasive.
Yeah. Socially abrasive, as they like to say, man. Why are you speaking so socially abrasive? Meaning you speaking hard, rough, loud, you got your volume at maybe an 8, 9, or a 10.
Straightforward.
I'm not beating around the fucking bush. we're not bringing you with that butter, man.
Well, I be rude in speech, not in knowledge.
That's right.
Clearly made manifest to you. Yeah.
That's right. We don't come at you with the roundabout truth. We're going to try to sneak you up in here. We got that 2x4 and just smacking you upside the head with it, man. As opposed to that motherfucking cracker that's going to lure you into the church. And then fuck you over mentally, man. And defile you. So it said what? The words of his mouth what?
Are smoother than butter.
Uh-huh.
But war was in his heart.
But war was in his heart, man. You can't tell me that's not the that's not the so-called white man. You cannot tell me, man.
Especially these church motherfuckers.
Especially, man.
Especially that white man in that damn church.
Especially. Listen, you know, white man, how many times you gotta hear about some damn Catholic motherfucker up in the Catholic church? And then you find out 2 months later that this motherfucker's been going over there in Bermuda or some one of them islands over there having sex with an 8-year-old boy, man. How many times you done heard that already? You got little ordinances for the Pope to kind of mask that shit now, man. Remember that?
Yeah.
He was like masking. It was so much of that pedophilia shit that them Catholics were doing. And he had to kind of suppress the shit because it was giving Catholicism a bad name, man.
Right.
It was giving Catholicism a bad name, man. Would that be the same motherfucker? Motherfuckers going up in there calling them, hey, father. Father, can you help me with this? Going into that little, you know, pit thing that they go. Where's the bar?
The
confession pit. Yeah. You telling this motherfucker everything, man, like he's God or something, man. Like he gonna forgive you, and this motherfucker's doing the most abominable shit ever, man. But words in his mouth is smoother than butter, man. But war was in his heart, man. These motherfuckers come at you with that smooth shit all the time, man. But they got war in their house,
boy. It's Isaiah 30:10.
Yep.
We'll say to the seer, see not, and to the prophet, prophesy not unto his right things,
prophesy to his not right things, what?
Speak unto his smooth things.
Smooth things.
Prophesy deceit.
Prophesy deceits, man. Prophesy deceits, man. When people come into these churches, man, they don't, honestly, they don't really go there to get the truth. She's happy, but she's not getting the truth.
Churches is a harlot house.
It's a harlot house. Would y'all agree with that? No? Why not?
When you go into church, you get that feel good for a second.
Right, you do. You get that one spiritual nut off, man.
Spiritual nut. You want to talk about love and shit? Love, guys, love. They start singing. Oh, love. Love. Right. And then motherfucker get happy.
Yep.
You bust that spiritual nut.
Mm-hmm.
And then you
then
fucking
pass
go
that
home.
Plate.
Yeah, pass the damn collection, that collection plate. Like, you got to pay for this spiritual fuck. And then your ass go home,
right.
And you good. It's the next Sunday. You got to get some more spiritual ass.
Exactly. 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 Spiritual ass. Yep.
And the Most High called that shit. The Most High said my people acted their stocks.
That's right.
Said they had committed adultery. That's because this shit is adult. That's you going to sleep with. That's that the churches are harlot houses, man. It's where you go to have sex, but spiritual sex. Get your mind fucked. Bust that mind nut real quick.
Right.
That happy mind nut.
Right.
And then go home and do it the next week.
Right.
Really, when you go into it, in the ancient days, the churches of the heathens had prostitutes in them. And you would go in there,
yeah.
And you would have sex with the prostitute, and you'd give her a gift, like money or something, and then she would say, your sins are forgiven.
Right.
That's how it was in the ancient days, not in Israel, but amongst these heathens. These damn churches ain't nothing but whorehouses. That's what we mean, spiritual whorehouses, man.
Right, right.
You're going to hear fucking all these different gods and these different philosophies.
Yeah. And it said prophesy deceits, man. So it's like the people really want, and it's talking about Jacob, man. How people want that shit up in there, man. You can't be up in the church and bring out what we bring, man. Because it's too controversial, man. It's too abrasive. Which will show you what? What should show you what? Is that these places, is the foundation of these places is money, business, man. Because that's something a publicist would tell you. Hey, man, you got to fix your image up, man. You can't say this, you can't say that. Even though I know you feel this way, you know, hey, you got to bring it out like this, but how it's going to look to the people. You don't want to lose fans. You don't want to lose supporters. You don't, yeah, exactly. You can't be too rough. You can't really necessarily tell the truth like you want to. That's what they doing here, man. Because if you ain't got asses in those seats, man, there's no money coming in.
Yep.
That's why you got these, you know, Jake and these
big
churches.
Big super churches.
Big super churches, man. Taking up the whole block. Taking up the whole entire block, man. They got campuses now.
Church campus. These churches down here got damn basketball gyms in them motherfuckers, like with
exactly
whole like indoor basketball gyms and
right.
Schools.
Mm-hmm. And schools, man.
K to 12.
Pastors got their own reality shows now.
Oh yeah. Yep. Exactly. Another reason why they can get so big like this, they don't pay taxes. 501c3s, man. Tax exemptions, man. To what? To prophesy a bunch of lies, man.
Yep. His words were softer than oil than were they drawn swords.
But were they drawn swords, man? But were they drawn swords? You got the troops going over to different countries. Basically, he's trying to talk like they're going over there to, you know, spread democracy, man. And then every time you see these little recordings going over to these other countries, man, these troops are just slaughtering these people, man. With these little, so what they call them, war crimes?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, they're going over there and them Iraqis, Iranians, man, they fighting real hard because they don't want this way of life, man. I don't blame them. I don't blame them for not wanting to come home to a nagging ass bitch, man, that doesn't respect you, man. You know what I'm saying? They don't want that, man.
That's blasphemy. That's what we just talking about.
What's up?
Blasphemy of them that dwell in heaven. The little statue right there.
Yeah.
It's a naked woman with angel, with wings on her back, like the angel just women and shit.
Right.
Exactly.
But this way of life is, this way of life over here is wicked, man. It's very, very wicked, man. And that's what they go over there to do, man. They go over there to pillage those people, rape them, take all the natural resources. And they wonder why, you know, they fighting so hard over there, man. Shit, if we could, man, we would fight. We would fight. Real shit, man. Real shit. You fight for your heritage, your culture, man. When you take away somebody's culture like that, man, their heritage, their history like that, man, you demolish them, man, because they don't have a foundation anymore. So I'll fight for that, too. I'd rather not just be alive if I can't have that.
You got a precept for you, man.
You got Isaiah or Psalm?
Psalms 155, hold on. Psalms 119. And on 61, the bands of the wicked have robbed me, but I have not forgotten thy law.
But I have not forgotten thy law, man. Go ahead.
Yeah, that's it. That's it on that. He got something.
Yeah, go ahead, Rob.
Psalms 55, verse 9. Destroy, O Lord, and divide their tongues, for I have seen violence and strife in the city.
Mm-hmm.
Day and night they go about it upon the walls thereof. Mischief also and sorrow are in the midst of it. Mm-hmm. Wickedness is in the midst of deceit, and God depart not from her streets.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, read it again, read it again.
Destroy, O Lord, and divide their tongues.
Yep.
For I have seen violence and strife in the city.
The Most High gonna destroy these damn tongues. He gonna do it literally and symbolic. That's why we out here. We out here to destroy their tongues or their doctrines. We are standing in front of two churches on this damn corner right here. We on goddamn church street. Go ahead.
Day and night they go about it upon the walls thereof. Mischief also and sorrow are in the midst of it.
Mischief and sorrow are in the midst of it, man. In the midst of what? In America. In America. And this shit starts with this church shit. They don't want to tell our people Jesus Christ is white. He's a white man. And the Bible is for the white man and all this shit like that. Knowing damn well, this Bible is not for them. It came from ancient people that were black. Go ahead.
Well, mischief also and sorrow in the midst of it. Wickedness is in the midst of deceit, and God depart not from her streets.
Wickedness is in the midst of, man, and what? Even these churches, man. These churches are wicked. Ain't nothing nice about these churches. They ain't teaching you no laws. They ain't teaching you about who the Israelites are. They ain't teaching you how to serve God. How you gonna serve God and you celebrate Christmas? How you gonna serve God and you ain't keeping the Passover? Or Hanukkah? Or the Day of Atonement? How you gonna serve God and you ain't keeping them days? How you gonna serve God and you out here committing spiritual adultery? How you gonna serve God and you out here committing, you letting homosexuals in the damn church? And then you talking against us like we wrong for saying the Most I said put their ass to death. Go ahead. Read that again that first.
Wickedness is in the midst thereof.
Wickedness is in the midst thereof. If it wasn't wickedness in America, we wouldn't be out here on these damn street corners, man. Go ahead.
Deceit and guile depart not from her streets.
Right. Deceit and guile. motherfucking deceit and guile, two deceit and guile things is sitting right on this damn corner. These churches. That's all that happened in a deceit. Deceiving people. Telling our people that they Gentiles. Oh no, you're a Gentile. You're a Gentile. No, the Gentile's gonna be saved, but you're a Gentile. Not letting them know who they are. They're the children of Israel. And the Gentiles will not be saved. It's not talking about you, Gentile. It's talking about the Israelites that were amongst you, that were calling themselves Gentiles. Go ahead.
All right, go back. You got a piece up? You want to bring out?
It's going on. 13?
Nah. Finish. Second Thessalonians.
Second Thessalonians 2:10.
Wait, it's been an hour?
I got time. Second Thessalonians 2:10. And with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth.
Yep.
That they might be saved.
Right.
And for this cause God shall send them strong delusion.
Right.
That they should believe a lie.
A lie. In these churches. Yep. Christianity.
Yep.
That's a lie, man. The first lie is that Jesus Christ was white. That's a fucking lie.
Yeah.
Second lie is that God is white. That's a damn lie.
God loves everybody.
Third lie is that the Gentiles can be saved. Or the heathens can be saved. That's a damn lie. The fourth lie is the people in Israel, is those are the chosen people, those are the Israelites. That's a damn lie. I mean, how many do we need to go through all of them? It wouldn't be enough time.
It's too many, yeah.
We'd be out here forever. Literally. Infinity. We'd be out here for an infinite amount of time trying to speak about all the lies perpetuated in these churches and in America.
I would, by the way. 100%.
That's right. It's big. Exactly. Just to speak on that real quick, the number one business in the world is the religion of Christianity.
Yeah.
Look it up.
What, they got 2 billion followers or something like that?
I don't know, but Christianity and these churches are businesses.
Yeah.
They're actually corporations. A corporation is a, how do you call it? A corporation is an entity formed by the government, an entity created by the government. It's actually a fictitious person. So when they fill out these 501c3 charters, they become recognized by the government. The government is their God and their creator. They become a fictitious person that can be recognized in a court of law.
Right.
That's why you get incorporated, so that you can be recognized and protected by the laws of in the Constitution of America, because your business is now a fictitious person. That's what these churches are. And it's the number one business in the world, Christianity. They sell things, they sell off the image, the false image that they perpetuated throughout the earth of a false Messiah, a white Messiah, and a white God. And they perpetuate these lies, which they sell for profit. And then their collection plate and all that shit like that. But go ahead.
It says, they all might be damned who believe not the truth.
That they all might be damned, condemned, that believe not the truth. You know what that mean? You don't believe not this word, you believe not this word, what you saying? Your ass is gonna be destroyed. In America, with these fucking heathens. If you're an Israelite, you don't believe what we're saying,
yeah.
These words we're speaking every week, your ass is going to be destroyed in America with the Americans, with the so-called white man.
Might be damned who believe not the truth, but have pleasure in unrighteousness.
Right, these damn churches.
Exactly.
Because they teach you unrighteousness. They teaching you that it ain't no laws. How you gonna have a God, how you gonna have a kingdom that has laws in it that says they go according to order of law, but then you got a God and he don't got no laws? That don't make no sense. It's like saying you better than God. Because you got law and order in your country, but then God don't got no law and order. He ain't get nobody laws. That don't make no damn sense. They teach unrighteousness in these churches.
Go ahead. Oh, Romans 1:32. It says, who knowing the judgment of God, that they which commit such things are worthy of death, not only do the same, but have pleasure in them that do them.
Right.
Because it said in Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians, that they have pleasure in unrighteousness. So it's not even just the fact that they're giving you lies. We already know that. That's already established. But the thing is, you willingly know that they're giving you lies and you go there. That's your judgment right there, man. Because you don't have to go in there. We don't. We know it's a house of lies. It's a harlot house, man. They're going to be feeding you a bunch of lies. If we do go up in there, we're going to be up in there condemning it. Shutting down all that bullshit.
Call the police on us.
And they're going to call the police on us because we're giving them truth. And we're not adding to the lies. So it says our people have pleasure in doing unrighteousness, man. What the brother was reading earlier, man.
Those that do them, man.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Those that do them, man.
So called white man.
But a white man, he seduces our people, man, into all this BS, man, and sin. And our people are like, all right, man, you know, hey, I'm going to just roll with this thing, man. I'm going to just roll with it. You know why? Because it feels good.
I feel good when I leave church.
Mm-hmm. I feel good. You got these white churches up in here, man. They'll go ahead and hire a black choir, man, to come up in there and sing in their fucking church. Because they know Jake got sold. You know what I'm saying? But also, that's a business move, man. Like the cracker just walked up. He said it's big business. It's big.
Yeah, it is. Micah chapter 2 verse 11. If a man walking in the spirit and falsehood do lie, saying, I will prophesy unto thee of wine and strong drink, he shall even be the prophet of this people.
Yes, right. See, that's all the Creflo Dollars, you know, and the TD Jakes, all of them cats, man. What's the name of the one guy that was having such a voice? Eddie Long, man. Y'all look at them as the, what they say, Eddie Long is our new king. That's scripture. Read that again.
Micah chapter 2 verse 10.
It's the Eddie Long scripture.
11. If a man walking in the spirit and falsehood do lie, saying I will prophesy unto thee of wine and strong drink, he shall even be a prophet to this people.
That's right. He shall even be a prophet to this people, man.
This place is wicked, man. You gonna mess up, you gonna have sex with little boys or whatever, and then you get rewarded for it. They make you king of Israel for it.
Right. A whole condom.
Fake?
No. It was a fake Jew. A fake Jew.
Fake Jew that said that?
A fake Jew put a crown upon this nigga head. Wow. And they held him up on their shoulders with the Torah and shit. Yeah.
Yeah, wrapped it around him and shit, yeah.
Yep. Wrap the Most High word around him, man.
That nigga's juiced in anyway. And Jake accepts it, though, man. Jake accepts it. They knew he was doing what he was doing, man. They was willingly still, hey, man. Well, you know, everybody, and nobody's perfect. What are you talking about, man? This motherfucker is evil, man. Is it more than that?
Nah, that was it. Isaiah chapter 30 verse 10, which say to the seer, see not, and to the prophets, prophesy not unto his right things, speak unto his smooth things, prophesy deceits.
Right.
Get ye out of the way, turn aside, out of the path, caused the Holy One of Israel to cease from before us.
Caused the Holy One of Israel to cease, what?
From before us.
From before us, man. That's Yahweh. What did Yahweh say, man? He is the volume of the book, man. He is the word. So when we come out here and tell Israel, you know, to stop, you know, committing sin, stop sleeping with your neighbor's wife, man.
Stop going to these fucking churches.
Stop going to these churches. Stop being deceived. Stop being a damn coon for the so-called white man. When we say that, they look at us like, hey, man, why would you teach us something like that, man? Get out of the way. We're comfortable, man. We're comfortable in this wickedness, man. That's why we can't wait, man. We can't wait for 2/3 of our people to go. Y'all gotta go. Y'all don't go, man. We're gonna be out here all for eternity, man. Basically. So y'all gotta get put to death. You going?
It says, wherefore, thus said the Holy One of Israel, because ye despise this word, and trust in oppression and perverseness.
Right. Perverseness, man. Perverse. You pervert this word, man.
Don't perverseness mean to twist.
Right. You know that the word perverse. Say get out of the way, man. Get out of the way of us doing what we're doing, man.
Yeah.
Brother, read the etymology.
Let's read the definition of perversion. Of a person. Perverse. Directed away from what is right or good. Perverted. Obstinately persistent in an error or fault. Wrongly self-willed or stubborn.
Right.
Marked by a disposition to oppose and contradict, arising from such a disposition.
That's right.
Cranky and peevish.
That's right. So basically, the opposite from what is right, man. Read that scripture again.
So it says, Amos 30:12, wherefore thus saith the Holy One of Israel,
yep.
Because ye despise this word,
mm-hmm.
and trust in oppression and perverseness,
mm-hmm.
and stay thereon. Therefore, this iniquity shall be to you as a breach ready to fall.
This iniquity will be to you as a breach ready to fall, man. As a breach ready to fall. I mean, your sins are racking up, man. Your sins is racking up and it's about to topple all over you, man. And it's like we're looking at you for just building them sins upon sins. We're telling you, hey, man, share what you're doing, man. Stop what you're doing, man. Come back to the ways of the Lord. And you just steady on building, man. Just like your daddy Esau, man. What did it say about Esau, man? His sins have reached to the heavens or something like that?
Oh, you talking about Revelation? Yeah, his sin reached up to heaven.
Mm-hmm.
To
heaven. They're going in the way of Esau, man. Of the unrighteous. And we're telling you to come back from that, man. Well, like we've been reading all day, y'all don't want to hear that. Because it's not smooth, go ahead.
Therefore, this iniquity shall be to you as a breach ready to fall,
mm-hmm.
swelling out in a high wall, whose breaking cometh suddenly at an instant.
Right. This motherfucker is about to pop, man.
Can I say something real quick?
Go ahead, man.
To show you how wicked these Edomites is, they don't like what we sin. So what they do, they walk past, and they look like they try to act like they're not looking. Then when they get past us, they turn around and they smile at us. Like, why are you smiling if you don't like what we're saying? That's what I'm saying. That's why scripture said his mouth, his words are smoother than butter.
Right.
But in his heart, his sword's drawn. And that's how these Edomites are.
Subtile, man.
Right, they subtile. They'll hide wickedness in their heart, man.
Matter of fact, go back to that. Isaiah 55. Go back to that real quick.
No, just gonna get you. Go back to where you were at Isaiah.
Is it Isaiah?
No, Isaiah. No, Isaiah 14:4. Right. That's how these Edomites are. When I say Edomites, I mean the so-called white men. That's how they are. They'll hide their wickedness under their tongue. Got it? No, Isaiah 14:2.
People should take them?
Yeah.
Well, Isaiah 14.
Sorry, verse like 3.
Isaiah 14 and 3. And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall give thee rest from thy sorrow.
Right.
And from thy fear.
Right. Good. Through there.
That thou shalt take up this proverb against the king of Babylon and say.
Right, that Babylon is America. Go ahead.
How have the oppressor ceased?
Babylon is Iraq.
The oppressor is ceased. Who is the oppressor of the world right now?
Right.
It's not Iraq. It's America. It's the so-called white man in America.
Died, but Babylon at that time was Iraq.
We're talking about Babylon today.
Right, modern day Babylon.
We're taking up a proverb against Babylon today, not ancient Babylon. We know that ancient Babylon was in Iraq. We're talking about modern Babylon. Give me Revelation chapter 18.
Yeah.
Come on, I'll get it quick.
It's Revelation
18:2.
18:2. And he cried mightily with a strong voice saying, Babylon the great is fallen, is fallen. And has become the habitation of devils and the hold of every foul spirit and the cage of every unclean and hateful bird.
Now this is a future prophecy, so this can't be talking about Iraq. Iraq is not a great power in the earth. Babylon the Great has been destroyed. The city of Babylon has been destroyed at this time when John the Revelator is prophesying. This can't be talking about Babylon of ancient times. This is modern Babylon.
Are you blood of Jews?
Yes.
We're Jews.
Cool.
Right. We're the real Jews. Some Jews over there in Israel, those are not the real Jews. Thus saith the Bible. You know what I want to ask?
Because they've been spread to all the world to teach about God's power.
That's right. That's right. Hey, listen to this.
Revelation 2:9.
Uh-huh.
I know thy works in tribulation and poverty.
They said, I know thy works in tribulation and poverty. Go ahead.
But thou art rich.
But thou art rich.
And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan.
They said, I know the blasphemy of them that say they are Jews, the ones that saying that they're Jews, and what? Are not, These are the real Jews. Because they said they're all over. You said they're scattered all across the world. And what? They're going through tribulation and poverty. They're in the hood and the ghetto. This is what it says in the Bible that this is going to happen to the real Jews. Oh, you know what I want. Isaiah. I'm sorry, Deuteronomy. This is what's going to happen to the real Israelites. The real Jews.
What is Edomite white man?
Say it again.
Edomite.
What's your question?
Because he is, he does not look like Jew.
Because he's not a Jew.
Right. That's why.
The Edomites are not Jews.
Mm-hmm.
See, you see this right here? These are ancient pictures of the Hebrews or Israelites, the Jews. You see that hair?
Yeah.
That don't look like it, like his hair.
Mm-hmm.
You see that hair? That's woolly.
Yeah.
Curly. Like our hair.
Uh-huh.
You see the hair on the side of my face?
Yeah.
Curly. You see that? That's how this hair is. These are the Jews. These are Jews. You see these braids? See like my hair?
Uh-huh.
See my hair is braided?
Uh-huh.
That's what these are. You see that? These
yeah.
are Jews. So we know that the Jews don't look like the people in Israel today.
Mm-hmm.
They were black people.
Uh-huh.
They kept black hairstyles.
Uh-huh.
The Edomites today are so-called white people. Like this man right here that he's standing on, that's
yeah.
the Edomite.
He's Scandinavian on this picture, but really, there was no Hebrew Scandinavian.
No, because the Hebrews were black.
Hebrew was from River Hebron.
Okay.
Hebron.
Yeah, Hebron.
The people who live above the Hebron, they've been called Hebrew.
Okay.
So
we know that the Hebrews were dark people. Because the people in the Middle East, well look, when you really look at Israel, it's in Asia, right? Which is the division that they divided the different continents today. But Israel is right next to Egypt, right? So the Israelites would have looked more like Egyptians rather than looking like Scandinavians.
Right.
I was today on the bus. I supposed to go to Presbyterian church, but I missed the bus stop.
That's good, man.
So I go farther, and there was Church of Christ, and they had on the other protection on head for baseball players, and one was mask of that looks like demon, like Satan with the horn.
Where?
Among the cast.
You gotta show, where is that at?
Church of Christ, kind of,
I wanna get a picture of that.
Color.
Uh-huh.
Which way is it? That way?
Yeah, this way.
Or is it down that way?
I go with the bus. That bus 7, 11, 18, and 40 goes near.
Okay. What street?
Is it this street?
Just behind the city, not that far behind the city. If you stay on the bus, you will not miss it.
Okay.
Because I did not miss. I saw this church. I passed this one.
Mm. And they had a demon in the church?
Yeah. And they sing, they sing hymns. They make Amazing Grace Day way and sing it to Jesus.
Mm.
They call Jesus God.
They call him God.
Yeah.
That's not right, is it?
There is only one God Almighty.
That's right.
And he gave us arbitrary Messiah that was called his son. And his name is Yeshua, or they call him Jesus. At Poland, they call him also Jesus.
At least you know that God and Jesus aren't the same.
Right.
That,
but
that's what they teach in the church, that God and Jesus is the same person.
They say also that there is only one God and his name is Jesus, and that he reincarnate himself.
Yeah, that's good.
And that is one God.
You know where that comes from? That comes from ancient Egypt. In ancient Egypt, they had three gods. And it was Isis, Horus, and Set. I think that's what it was. Isis, Horus, and Set.
But you know what?
But they were one God. They were supposed to be all one God, so we get the Holy Trinity from. And then the one God, he incarnated himself as a man on the earth, and he was supposed to be like the savior for men or something like that. But he was supposed to be his father. That's what they say, that Jesus is supposed to be God. It comes from ancient heathen worship, pagan gods. Yeah.
You see, I was there because God wanted me to go and see things.
Right.
And I showed them
so
my life.
So you can tell us.
And I told them, I prayed a prayer that Jesus brought us to pray to his Father, God Almighty, Jehovah. Yeah. And they don't know Jehovah. They know only one God named Jesus.
The white God, Jesus. Is that him right there?
Yeah.
They only know one God named Jesus.
They mislead people.
Yeah, were you just reading that?
We were just saying
they deceitful. They just spread lies. And they said the people take pleasure in hearing lies.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, why would you want to hear a lie? Why?
They don't think. They follow without thinking.
Right. They said the blind shall lead the blind.
And they're going to fall in the ditch. When I told them, this is that I prayed that Jesus brought us to pray to his Father, God Almighty, Jehovah, they came back. They didn't want to hear it.
Where'd you get that picture?
I was on the bus from Reno, Nevada to Sacramento, California. I cried and I had butterfly in stomach. I didn't say one word loud. I cried and prayed, and suddenly this light came and shined on me and changed my feeling. All this butterfly
right
was washed away.
That light right there?
Took that picture on the bus?
Yeah.
You took that picture?
Yeah. I have it on That's other terrible. Places. I have it in other places.
Do you know what that is?
This angel of Holy Spirit. It came from God. It came from God. I am God. I am in worship. I am one God Almighty. Total.
Can you put the camera so we can see it?
It looked like a cherry, man.
Yeah.
It looked like the cherry of fire. Hey,
You said you were in Reno, Nevada?
I was 20 years in Carson City, Nevada, and God pulled me, and now I preach and I travel and show people, and I preach mercy and repentance. God choose for me to preach only mercy and repentance. Those who show mercy to other people will receive it back in the time when they need it, and those who repent will have God's forgiveness of sins and life eternal in paradise after the tribulation, because heaven is God's kingdom. For his angels and saints, for mankind was given, paradise was taken from us, and is waiting for those who choose God.
Where are you from?
If we choose God,
Russia.
I am from
Romania?
Mountains area at Poland, from
Poland?
Village in Mountains area, and God will show me most beautiful places all over the world.
Poland, huh?
I am from Mountains area.
Oh, shoot.
You know how many people would like to come from America, from Poland to America? And God chose me. So many. And God chose me from Little Village.
Why do they want to come
here? You see, not only from Poland, but people think that America has opportunities for all people.
Does it?
From all over the world.
Does it?
No, I have a Polish diploma, but if God chose for me, I was receiving great things. finally, when I hear this call, I changed. I was thinking, now there is no other way.
What happened with that light?
I just have to ask what to do.
What happened with that light? You said you took those pictures?
Yeah, and you know?
Do you know what that is?
Angel or Holy Spirit, but it came to me when I prayed to God Almighty Jehovah.
Do you know that in the Bible that it speaks about devices that the angels ride in that look like that? Did you know that?
Bring it out.
Did you know that?
Angels,
they ride in devices that look like that. Did you know that?
Someone told me that it might be angel or Holy Spirit. That's what is understanding that came to
it's
from
a
me.
It's what we call God. A chariot. You ever read in Exodus and in
I read few times.
It says that over the children of Israel was a cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. That's
pillar,
what that is.
Pillar of light or fire.
That's
pillar.
What that is.
Yeah.
It's a chariot. That's what angels. That's what the angels travel in. It's like a vehicle, kind of like a car.
Oh.
And the angels travel from here to here and then back to.
Yay. That's
what, traveling
over. You see, I saw this light very near bus, and suddenly I saw it very far, and I didn't know how it get there.
Because they have advanced technology. This is the God that created the heavens and the earth. So he has advanced knowledge of everything.
Yeah.
So he can create these devices that's basically light that can travel at the speed of sound or even faster. So it might be here and you close, you blink and then it's way down
yeah,
there.
That's what happened.
Well, it says that God is the God of wisdom, of knowledge.
Uh-huh.
So he knows how to do everything. So he can create devices like that for the angels to traveling back and forth to his dimension and
uh-huh.
then to our dimension.
And you know, and it is written in about Solomon that
mm-hmm.
his the body of Hebrew was color of wood of cedar. Wood of cedar is brown.
Brown. Right.
I have box of wood of cedar because from cedar was built temple of God that Solomon
right.
built temple.
Right.
It was made from cedar because cedar was light to carry and they had it. So
you know that the Israelites were a brown people and not
yeah,
like that.
Yeah. Cedar, I find out that cedar was in white color.
Right. So, okay, well.
Wow.
That's powerful, man.
That's powerful, man.
Yeah, read that Revelation 1 and read that Revelation, not Revelation 3 and 9.
It's yeah. Revelation 3 verse 9. Behold,
that's
I will
crazy.
Make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not.
The people in Israel that say they're Jews and they're not. They're not the real Jews, but they say they are. What is God going to make them do?
Say they are Jews and they're not, but do lie.
But do lie. They're lying. In the churches, they lie and they tell you that the people in Israel, those are the Jews. You got to love Israel over there. Those are not the Jews. Those are people that came from your area, Poland and places like that. Go ahead.
Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet.
They're going
to
worship before the feet of the real Jews, which is us. These people, the Negroes in America are Jews. The Hispanics are Jews. People that lived in America, Native Americans. And Negroes are the real Jews. Go ahead.
I will make them worship before thy feet and to know that I have loved thee.
Uh-huh.
Right. Go ahead.
Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth.
That's it. Right. So, in the end, everybody's going to know who the real Jews are. And it's not those people in Israel. It's the so-called Negroes. Those are the chosen people of the Most High God. And it's funny, I wanted to say this earlier.
You see, really, that was the...
Oh, that's sandalwood?
That is the cedar. But it's not like white. That is the cedar.
Oh, that's it right there?
Yeah. It's more like
a brown color.
But it's not bright. I
right.
Go to Revelation. Go to Revelation 13 again. Go back. We're gonna go back. Go back. Mm-hmm. Check. Revelation 13.
13.
Yeah.
It's Revelation 13 verse 10.
No. Revelation 13 and 8 and 6.
13 verse 6.
Verse 5.
5. And there was given unto him a mouth speaking great things and blasphemies, and power was given unto him to continue 42 months.
Right.
And he opened his mouth and blasphemy against the Most High, to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle and them that dwelt in heaven.
Right. To blaspheme the Most High name, his tabernacle, and them that dwell in heaven. Also his people. Now, I'll tell you another thing. The angels are dark. When they come down, the angels don't have bodies.
Right.
They're spirits, they're energy, like that light you see.
Yeah.
That's
what
angels are, energy like that. They don't have bodies, but when they come down on the earth, they manifest themselves as men. And when they do, they manifest themselves in the color of brown. And we could go to Ezekiel. Go to Ezekiel chapter 1. We'll show that. The angels are, they manifest themselves unto men as brown. But when you go into church, you see all, you see these images of all the angels, and they're white. And then you see Jesus, he's white. And you see God, and he's white. And everybody, Peter, he's white. And the apostles, they're white. But that's not the truth. That's a lie. That's a blasphemy that's been committed in these churches. Ezekiel chapter 1. Go to Ezekiel chapter 1. Hold on. Ezekiel chapter 1. Verse, let me get this. Ezekiel chapter 1, verse 4. Nope. Ezekiel chapter 1, starting verse 4.
Ezekiel 1 and 4. And I looked, and behold, a whirlwind came out of the north, a great cloud and a fire enfolding itself, and the brightness was about it.
A great cloud and a fire enfolding itself, meaning it looked like a cloud, but it had a fire around it, like light. The ancients didn't have electricity and light.
Right.
So they described anything that was like a light, like your picture, they would describe it as fire.
Mm-hmm.
So they were seeing what you seen on that picture.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
And the brightness was about it, and out of the midst thereof, that's the color of amber, out of the midst of the fire.
Yeah.
Yep, go ahead.
Also out of the midst thereof came the likeness of four living creatures, and this was their appearance.
Now out of this light came four creatures. Now this light is a device that they use to ride in, kind of like we ride in cars. And out of this device came four creatures. This is what Ezekiel is saying, go ahead.
They had the likeness of a man, and everyone had four faces.
Right.
And everyone had four wings.
Right.
And their feet were straight feet.
They said they had the likeness of a man, meaning they, to Ezekiel, they showed themselves as men. Okay, the angels, go ahead.
And the sole of their feet was like the sole of a calf's foot.
Right.
And they sparkled like the color of burnished brass.
They sparkled like what?
The color of burnished brass.
Burnished brass. Like brass has been burnt. And when you have brass that's been burnt, it's more like that wood. It's a darker color. It's a darker brown. So that's what the angels look like. So this guy of the Bible and the angels, when they show themselves to men, they show themselves as dark. Now go to James chapter 7, I think it's verse 21. We'll read about the God of the Bible. When he showed himself to Daniel, how did he show himself as looking?
Do you know that at Poland was miracle and Mary show up as a black woman?
Say that again.
At Poland long time ago was a miracle, and Mary appeared to people like a black woman.
Mary appeared to people as a black woman in Poland?
Yeah, it is in the city of Częstochowa. That's how they call the city.
Okay.
But you know, on the pictures from the beginning, it has
black.
Dark face.
See?
Oh.
That's crazy.
Y'all praise y'all.
You got that sign, man?
They did not lie on the... They did not lie. They says how it looks.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
They
change it over there. They change it.
So she showed us as a black woman?
Yeah. It is since 1400.
1400s?
Yeah. When Carl Gustavus, that was Scandinavian.
What's his name again?
Carl Gustavus.
Carol Gustav?
Gustavus. Gustav is okay.
Look that up.
Gustav. Carol Gustavus.
Gustavus.
Okay. Yeah. He was attacking Poland, constantly want to get to mainland, and they marry, show up to people and told them, build here fence, and
build a fence?
Build here fence, because he's coming, and the fence will protect us, you from Carol Gustavus, and people just built for fast a fence, very strong fence, and he came. He came a little bit too late because they just finished with the fence.
So Mary showed up as a black woman.
Yeah.
And is that well known?
What to do, and she scared the people.
Is that well known in Poland?
It is holy place for now, forever.
It's a holy place in Poland?
Yeah. Forever.
Wow.
People go from so far there.
Is it a national monument in Poland?
Probably it is not like national monument because they're giving this name only to not church related.
Oh, okay, government.
Yeah.
Okay.
Artistic.
But it is for the people.
But and people saw that the advice was good. They designed to build their church. So first they built a small church, but after they get miracle prosperity. And they were growing good, and they built very gigantic.
Well, they built a church on the site where Mary showed up as a black woman.
Yeah, and she helped them. She helped them build the church. The power that was in this ground was holy, and keep them safe. And he never competed this place.
So let me ask you something. Where you from? Is it a thing called the Black Madonna, like where they have a statue?
Yeah, they Black Madonna.
They have that there?
The little baby.
And was that like, is that a black woman and a black child, or what is that?
Both are black, little baby and Mary.
So that's supposed to be Mary and Jesus?
And she has the light around her. Okay. The light, yellow light around.
And that's what they have in Poland?
Yeah.
And this is a real statue? Have you seen it before?
You know, first there was only painting of her face
painting?
As a first, and they keep it black.
Okay.
And after they start making postures, but they keeping her black.
Is it still like that today?
Yeah.
Do sometimes they paint them white?
You see, not always. Believers, they want for business.
We're just talking about that.
That's
and
crazy.
They want it to be sold. So black people don't come to Poland. But if you make it white, they will buy it. So they start making it white.
We're just talking about that. About how in the churches and they sell images. So yeah, we're just talking about that.
Lately, they make statues with some kind of, but pictures are still the same Mary black.
Right. Where are those?
Whatever are the same black people.
Where are they? Like, are they hid in the museum? Are they in the museum?
No.
Everybody said they put away.
No. Yes. You know what is about the picture? It is on the center altar.
Oh, okay.
And it's closed. But at the appointed time,
close it up, and then only on special occasions they open it.
Yeah, there is few times that they uncovering the picture that they hold.
Okay.
And they hide it again.
Okay. That's wow.
And I know the miracles happen that people from so far go there. Only, you know, not everybody can receive miracle.
Right.
To receive miracle, you have to ask for forgiveness of sins. And you have to ask God to reverse generational curses that can be imposed on you, on us. Three lines of ancestors can impose curses on one person. Parents, grandparents, and great-grandparents. So if you ask God to reverse generational curses on you, they will be reversed and ask for forgiveness of sins. Those who, and God promised, those who repent will have his forgiveness of sins and life eternal in paradise after the tribulation. So once we rid of sins and generational curses, we receive miracles. There is nothing to stop us. All you have to ask for it. Ask and you receive. Ask specifically what you want. God can direct steps of stranger to give you job. Sometimes if you ask, lead a business people to me to offer me job, to give me good pay job. If you ask for forgiveness of stranger and you ask for it, there is nothing to stop you. God will lead someone to give you a business card and come to my office.
You know why you came? Do you know why you came and walked past us today? No. Let me go to chapter 33, verse 15. Like you just said, God will lead you to places sometimes. Well, all the things that you talked about, like the images being black, like the money, they changed the image so that they could sell it to tourists. We were talking about all those things before you came. So God led you here so that you could tell us about your country and about the things in your country, the holy things in your country, so that it could confirm what we were saying, you know, earlier.
I know God does things in my life because so many times he brings me to churches where it's party.
Right.
They have 50 years of existing of the church.
Yeah.
And just in this day, God brought me there.
Right. Then we're going to read this real quick.
He told, chapter 33, verse 15, in a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falleth upon men, and slumberings upon the bed, then he openeth the ears of men and sealeth their instruction, that he may withdraw man from his purpose and hide pride from man. He keepeth back his soul from the pit.
That's it. So at night when you sleep, God seals in your instruction for the next day. So you might have thought, oh, I'm going to the movies today, but then nope, you end up coming across here because the Most High God controls your actions to make you do what he wants you to do and not what you want to do.
You know, God shows me things in my dream. I forget it, and suddenly, I am in situation that was in my dream.
Yeah.
And I recall it was already in my dream.
Yeah, I know what you mean. It happened to me a lot of times. Like, I did this already. I remember this.
Yeah.
I know. I say it all the time.
Sometimes when I have dreams, I was thinking, why did God make this dream not come to me?
Revelation chapter 12, verse
7. And I was in Atlanta, and there is... I came to Atlanta, and I didn't know where to go for night. And I asked people, where is a woman's shelter here? And they says, there is one shelter on the street, but there is both woman and man. And I was like, okay, it's not that far, I will go there. And I get to the one room full of metal chairs and seated people, and there was all black people. there was only very weak light, the place looked scary.
Right.
And that's how they spend night, sitting on the metal chairs.
Well, remember we read that scripture earlier.
But I saw it in my nightmare, and I was like...
You saw it in your nightmare? Was a nightmare?
And when I came there, it revealed to me, I saw it in my nightmare, and I'm here. So I pray for that. I ask nothing, you know.
That happened really? Yes. Like you really went somewhere in that day?
I was there.
Oh.
And when I came to this place, I recalled, oh, it shocked me. I saw it in my nightmare. But right. God wanted me to go there to pray with them. God wanted me to pray. God wanted me to preach in Atlanta mercy and repent. But evil was so horrible, strong on me. Evil was hurting me then. And you know, I was crying inside. They were without future. The young men see big hall of people, like hundreds of people.
Okay.
More than
that. It's Revelation 12 and 14. And to the women were given two wings of a great eagle.
This woman represents Israel. Go ahead.
That she might flee into the wilderness into a place.
Which is Africa. Go ahead.
Where she is nourished for a time.
Which is America. Go ahead.
And times, and a half a time in the face of the serpent.
Go ahead.
When the serpent casts out of his mouth water as a flood.
Yeah, that water represents the philosophies of like this image of this white Jesus that's false. Like the images
doctrine,
of Mary.
False doctrine.
Right, false doctrine. Go ahead, keep going. That he tells our people, he tells the real Jews that they're not the Jews. Like he tells our people, which are the Jews, Negroes, which are the Jews, he tells them that you're not Jews. You're Gentile. You're not Jews. You're not the chosen people. Jesus Christ didn't look like you. He looked like us. He looked like he was Jesus Christ's wife. That's all false doctrine that he cast out of his mouth. They teach that in school. Keep going.
After the woman, and he might cause her to be carried away of the flood.
Right. You know what? I recall something.
Hold on.
And the earth helped the woman, and the earth opened her mouth.
How does the earth open its mouth? Because of the pictures, the archaeology, and the different pictures and paintings from the ancient days and from the past. Like she was just telling us about the Mary being black on the photos in Europe. She said that they close up the photos. I mean, they close up the pictures only for certain times, and then the tourists, they sell the tourists white images. It's because they know black people are not gonna go over there. Black people don't go over there often. And if they do go, they're gonna get the white image, and they're gonna think that Mary and Jesus and all of them was white.
I would advise you to read Solomon's songs. He said, because my brothers make me plant a vineyard, that my this is black like heaven.
Right.
That's what he said. They supposed to, there is like, they make him do vineyard and he is tent and he look like heaven.
Right. You sons of Solomon, you know the Sons of Solomon? I'm black and comely.
1 and 5, 1 and 3.
Get it.
Song of Solomon, 1 verse 5.
That's not the one she's talking about. Oh. Yeah, go ahead.
I am black, but holy.
Yeah, you see?
Yeah.
O ye daughters of Jerusalem, as the tents of Kedar, as the tents of Solomon.
You know what Kedar means? Kedar means dark. He says, I am black and comely as the tents of Kedar. The tents of Kedar were dark colored. That word Kedar, for dark in Hebrew means dark. When you go into the ancients, the Greeks called everybody in Africa and in Asia, they called them Ethiops, Ethiopia, Ethiops. Ethi means burnt, and ops means face in Greek.
Oh.
So And the reason they called them that, because they said that the sun had burnt their faces. So that's why right here it says, look not upon me, for I am dark, because the sun has kissed me. But that relates directly to the Greeks being a white people, calling the Israelites, the people in Asia and the people in Africa, Ethiopians, or burnt faces, because the sun had burnt them. So that correlates. Go to verse, what is it? Chapter 8?
8 and 11.
Go to 8 and 11.
Song of Solomon, chapter 8, verse 11. Solomon had a vineyard at Baal Hamon. He let out the vineyard unto keepers. Everyone for the fruit thereof was to bring 1,000 pieces of silver. My vineyard, which is mine, is before me, thou, O Solomon, must have 1,000, and those that keep the fruit thereof, 200. What's the one out? Those that...
No, that's not it. I know she's talking.
8 and 12 or 8 and 11? That was 11 already?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was saying about the brothers. His brothers made him keep a vineyard or something like that. But give me all Daniel chapter 7. New Daniel chapter 7, I think it's verse 21. Yeah. Hashemayim wa'ath ha'al ha'ar ha'ar latazal.
Am I
Lord
right?
God, in the beginning, God created heaven and earth.
That's what it is?
Yes, Genesis 1 and 1.
Because you see, one time God lead me far from the city. I go with the trolley in San Diego. I go with the bus. And when people leave bus, I feel like I want to go other direction, not with the people to the town. And there I walk 20 minutes. I had the patience, but I feel like I like to go there. God made me like to walk this way. And finally I stand in front of the back of the building, and I was thinking, something must be here. The building is big. And I walked around, and there was parking lot full of cars. It was Saturday, it was Jewish temple.
Oh.
And
in
the same day, they had someone from New York that teach them Hebrew alphabet and numbers. And they told us that we just need and you will love you, that for all of you, that for all of you, that for all of you.
Right, but that's Jewish chapter 1. That's not in there. That's Genesis chapter 1.
Maybe I took the other piece.
Yep, see, look. This is Ba-da-ash-ya.
In the beginning.
In the beginning. Ba-da-a. Ba-da, which is in the beginning, created Alachayim, the God, or God, powers, Ath, Hashemayim, the heavens, Wa'ath, and the Ha'aratizah, the Aratizah earth. So, yeah, that's Genesis 1 and 1. That's Genesis 1 and 1.
And you see, they like my life. They like my life. Mm-hmm. They let me make a picture of Torah. They said,
you got that from them?
Yeah.
The alphabet too came out the Torah?
It was from the same place. You see the Torah? The same time they didn't make Peter.
But that's what we were saying. You know those are not the real Israelites, right?
This was Messianic Temple. That's how they called this place.
But you know that those are not the real ancient Israelites, like Jesus?
That's what I was astonished. That was so many blonde people. There was blonde.
They converted to the religion of Jesus.
But they are not Hebrew. They are not blonde Hebrew.
No. You know that?
They're not Hebrew.
Israelites.
Right. They're Hebrew.
They're Hebrew Edomites.
But they're not Israelites.
Right.
They're not the same people as Jesus was.
Right.
They're Edomites.
Uh-huh.
You know Jacob?
Uh-huh.
Remember Jacob?
Uh-huh.
Israel? Remember he had a brother?
Yeah.
And his brother's name was Esau?
Uh-huh.
That's what they are. They're Edomites.
Edomites?
Yes.
Esau.
Esau. Yeah.
Right.
They're the brothers.
Right.
They're the brother nation uh-huh. of the Jews.
Uh-huh.
They're our brother yeah. nation.
Uh-huh.
Right. So, yeah, it was good talking to you. I'm glad you came and showed us the thing, told us the things you told
things
us.
Things happen in Christmas.
Right.
I see now that it's like God made it.
Right, right.
And they used to be this way.
Right. Yeah. So, Joel 33:15. We show your instructions. So whatever you do today, that's what he wanted you to do.
Yeah. He's planning today and sometimes we don't follow God. But
right.
I do follow. I am in his command. And he wants to lead me. I miss this church because God won't show the church that worship Jesus. And I showed them my pictures, but they went around dead. They came back. They didn't want to say about that. I prayed prayer that Jesus brought us to pray to his Father, God Almighty.
They didn't want to see your pictures?
They don't want to hear name Yahweh. They don't want to.
What they want to hear?
Jesus.
Jesus?
They think that was Jesus, the light.
You said it was Jesus?
They are taught to believe that there is only one God and his name is Jesus. And he reincarnated in the baby and became Jesus, son of Mary.
So Jesus prayed to himself in the Bible.
Yeah, that's what he said. And when I tell them that was the time when Jesus was baptized in Jordan and God, when the sky came to people,
right.
This is my beloved son.
Right.
I'm pleased with him. He
right.
Is
exactly.
He right. Told them that?
Cutting that ass up, man. That's right. That's the perfect scripture to bring out on that. That's the perfect scripture because it says, he's my son, hear him. Why would he say, hear? It doesn't make sense. Hear me. And he's, that doesn't make sense. He's talking to himself.
God gave him Holy Spirit and he was able to do miracles. Before he was a rabbi and he was teaching Torah, Talmud, God's word in Hebrew. Talmud is in other language. His translated Torah.
Babylonian. Talmud is Babylonian.
And you see, Babylonian created, not created, but they have like Islamic people that they, Islam always fight with Jews.
Yep. I got the script. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 6. This is why, you know, see, this is why they're not teaching the truth in the churches.
No,
because
don't.
The Bible itself says that God and his son is different. They're a different entity, right? It says 1 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 6. But unto us, there is but one God, the Father, of whom are all things, and we in him, and one the Lord Jesus Christ,
yeah,
by whom are all things, and we by him. Meaning that they're two different entities.
Yeah.
They're not the same. They're not. They're not the same person.
When was it, 1 Corinthians?
1 Corinthians 8 and 6. I'll read it again. 1 Corinthians 8 and 6. But to us, there is but one God, the Father, of whom all things, and we in him, and one Lord, Jesus Christ, by whom are all things, and we by him. Two different people.
Yeah.
Right.
So, you know, that's... Then Christianity, especially in America, this Christianity, this is not really according to the Bible. Okay?
Are you from Jamaica?
My dad is.
Probably. Because the song I know.
You know the song?
I could just... One time was a stand and they had music, Jamaica's music.
Mm.
And I could just from them. That is kind of music.
You like that music?
I like.
Yeah.
I don't understand the words, but that is pretty music.
Right. It's a lot of it is spiritual. You like Bob Marley? Oh, you don't know Bob Marley?
I don't know who was. I don't know.
With the dreads. Yeah, the long dreads. With the guitar.
It was beautiful. That's why I could sing.
Okay.
I don't no longer
care of things. Now I have my things on my hands. So, who's John Wanamaker? John
Wanamaker. The limo doesn't go today?
What?
The limo does not go today?
Limo? Oh, the bus? I don't know. You're waiting on the bus?
Ain't no bus stop, is it?
I might go across and give the bus to McDonald's and have some lunch.
Oh, okay.
All right, you have a nice day.
It was nice meeting you. What's your name?
Christina. Is something
Christina.
Else what I can... That I will not think it was missed. So you know, in us lives spirit of life that is constantly connected with God, and God knows whatever we think, whatever we do, all of us, even those who disbelieve in God. God knows their thoughts and deeds.
The discernment of thoughts. Yep.
I pray.
Your spirit is borrowed from God. All the spirits on the earth are borrowed from God. It's His spirit.
This belongs to God. All of the spirits of people belong to God.
Right.
How come they are not afraid to do bad things that God punishes?
Because they're wicked. Because they're wicked, that's why. They're rebellious. These are the same people. These are the same people because spirits are like water. You know, the water cycle, like it rains. The water settles like the water over there. The sun hits it, and then that same water evaporates up, goes in the clouds, and then it rains down. It does the same thing. It's a cycle. God, when He created things, He created everything in cycles. So spirits have cycles too. So when we die, our spirit goes back to God.
Yeah.
And then it comes back down in the body again on earth.
You see.
They go back up.
You see, there is not anymore like that. Because
still
now,
like that.
No, because you know what?
Mm.
The Torah was given 3,500 years before Christ was born.
Okay.
Now it's 2,014 years. That is 5,514 years.
Okay.
And before already was people on the earth. That means 6,000 years is ending.
Mm.
6,000 years is ending.
Okay.
6,000 years was the period of the time this destined for mankind as a test if we choose God or evil.
Okay.
And those who die, they soul go to place of rest and waiting for the tribulation. And at one time, there will be main judgment of all mankind. At that time, tribulation, there will be two groups of things. Those who believe in, those who choose God, and those who choose the evil. And those who choose evil, they will go to the darkness. Because there is only light and darkness, and there is no hell. Hell was described like a fire, but there is darkness, and the soul of those who didn't choose God will be tormented for the rest of forever.
You know, the place, you know, Puerto Rico.
Ecclesiastes 1 and 9. He created her and saw her and numbered her and poured her out upon all his works. She is with all flesh.
Wait.
So I know that there is place where God collecting our souls and they resting.
Right?
And when you sleep, you don't know how long you sleep. All
that,
the
is
souls,
that a place of judgment?
No, there is place where our soul resting and waiting for the tribulation. Our souls are collected, and it's easy to collect souls because they are very, you know, that they are like fog.
Ecclesiastes 1:9. The thing that hath been, it is that which shall be, and that which is done, is that which shall be done, and there is no new thing under the sun.
So we're under the sun, right? And then we're not new. Our spirits are old, disciple spirits. Now go jump to Sirach 11 and 9.
No, please.
Watch, you gotta listen, watch. So I'm gonna show you.
There is a place for our souls.
It is.
Waiting for tribulation.
11 and 9.
It's the rock. It's the rock 12 and 7. Give unto the good and help not the sinner.
No.
That is good too. That is not good. That is good to make evil take care of evil. Because evil comes to us smoking and asking, give me.
There we go.
Then shall the dust return to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall return unto God who gave it.
Yeah, there is one
God in hell.
Yeah, there is one place when our souls resting and waiting for the tribulation.
Is God there?
You know what happened to me?
Well, how about, is God in that place where the souls go?
Probably there are God's angels and manage everything.
But, read that again.
Then
shall the dust return to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall return unto God who gave it.
When you die, your spirit goes to God who gave it.
I know, because I died. When I was 9 years old, I was on the ski slope, and God called me. Show me what you can do. My God, I said to me, don't do that. There is ice under this black slope. But God said, I give you 100 Polish money if you slide down.
100 Polish
money? Polish money, 100 zloty, Polish money. Polish currency.
Okay.
And you know what? I was told obey that because God wants us to obey that. And I was thinking, if God wants me to obey that, he will take care of me. I was like, okay, that. I jump fast. On the center under the ski jump, I bent myself very, and you know, without breath, I slid down like very fast. And down I supposed to make the maneuver to stop, but when I did the maneuver, I slid and I wrecked my body on the, that was ice, and I slid and I wrecked my body. First short moment, I feel burning pain, and after it was gone. But my invisible me was vacuumed to the place, and I traveled very fast as invisible me, and I get to the place when was beautiful light. And my invisible me knew someone that and asked, not now please, not now. That will give me money. I will go shopping. I cannot stay here now. wondered, but I don't remember if I haven't seen that place.
So how did you know? So how did you know that the that place is where the souls had to stay at the judgment?
And you know?
How did you know that?
You know, this place was when God vacuum, like, give my soul to this place because I died and I supposed to stay there.
So how did you know that you were supposed to stay in that place forever?
This, my invisible me knew it. This invisible me knew. And that's why I was asking to let me go back. And after I saw my flesh down on the snow, and I was thinking, it's me. Yeah. And after,
but that place, you don't stay forever.
And after I get to the flesh, it was horrible thing. I was wet and dirty because all people losing liquids were fluids when they die. They're no longer warm, you know. And Dad was waiting for ambulance, but he go to store to call off ambulance, and doctor told him to check my, to test urine for internal bleeding, and in my urine was blood. And they whispered, only God can help her, but don't know where the blood comes from. And they told me, lay down, rest, so I fell asleep. And before I woke up at morning, that early morning, I hear a voice that said above my bed, you have new kids. And I was like, I open eyes and nobody was there. I go to grandma and I told her, grandma, someone told me you have new kids. But nobody was involved. My sister said.
Give me a second.
And you know, grandma told me,
go
pee to the jar and you will see there will be no blood in your urine. And in the urine was no blood. I asked grandma, how did you know that there will be no blood? You see, grandma told me, you see, because the voice said that you have new kidney and God knows what was wrong. And he gave you new kidney. And now you will be fine. And she gave me a hug. And I was like, grandma, how God gave me new kidney? Grandma said, miraculously, just like Jesus when was among us on the earth. And I feel so special. And I have my miracle. And I couldn't wait when Paris come back from work. And I told them what happened. How I was traveling with the tube of the beautiful light up to the very high.
The spirit world.
To the
chambers.
Invisible.
You know that place is called the Chamber of Souls.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah,
because
it's in the Bible. You want to hear about it?
Yeah, wait a minute, because it's important right now. And you know, and when they came from work, I told them what happened, and they forbid me talk about that. They said, because people will think you stroke head and get crazy. And I didn't talk about that, and I forgot about that. And in 2001 year, I have sick kidneys and x-rays. Doctor make x-rays and look at the light and said, and you have three kidneys. One is smaller and is not functioning. My miracle is with me. My broken, damaged kidney is still there. It wasn't growing since accident. The other good one that God gave me was growing.
Wow.
Yeah.
Girl, read this. Wait, first, before you read that, read 2 Ezra chapter 5, verse 41.
2 Ezra 5.
Start at verse 40.
2 Ezra 5 and 40. Then said he unto me, like as thou canst do none of these things that I have spoken of, even so canst thou not find out my judgment, or in the end, the love that I have promised unto my people. And I said, behold, O Lord, yet art thou nigh unto them that be reserved to the end. And what shall they do that have been before me, or we definitely not.
What does it mean, them that be reserved to the end? You're talking about the elect, 144,000, meaning that they're going to be saved from the destruction at the end. Keep going.
Okay, but so come after it. And he said it to me, I would liken my judgment to a ring, like if there is no slackness of the last, even so there is no swiftness of the first.
Meaning a ring, a circle represents eternity. It also represents a cycle.
It's like so, that.
Well, you could do it like that, or you could just do a circle, because a circle never ends. It never has a beginning or an ending. That's what he's saying. Now, go back to what I told you to get, 2 Exodus chapter 4, verse 40. Because that's how God's judgments are, his judgments. I mean, his things, the things that he's created is always in a circle. Everything has a cycle, because that's how things will work for an eternity. If you want something to last forever, it has to have a cycle to renew itself. Okay, go ahead.
2 Ezra 4 and 40. So he answered me and said, go thy way to a woman with child and ask of her when she hath fulfilled her 9 months, if her womb may keep the birth any longer within her. Then said I, no, Lord, that can she not. And he said unto me, in the grave, the chambers of souls are like the womb of a woman.
Read that again.
Wow.
And the what?
Then said I, no, Lord, that can she not. And he said unto me, in the grave.
In the grave.
The chambers of souls.
The chamber, where you went, the chambers of souls, that's where you was. Where you went to the light, that's the chambers of souls. Go ahead.
Are like the womb of a woman.
They're like the womb of a woman, like the woman that's pregnant. Go ahead.
For like as a woman that travels, making haste to escape the necessity of the travail.
As a woman that's pregnant, she has the birth pains, as she want to get the baby out, so is this thing. Go ahead.
Even so do these places haste to deliver those things that are committed unto them.
Which are, what is committed to the chamber of souls? Souls, people that die. They go to the chamber of souls, and the chamber of souls hastes to deliver them or to put them out back into the earth, because it's a cycle.
Wow. So tell me one more time, which Isaiah?
What scripture? That's 2 Ezra.
Ezra. Oh, that is not in my ears.
Because you have the new book. You have to get the 1611, the King James Bible. They took this out of the Bible.
Uh-huh, they didn't. There is not in my Bible.
You have to get a new Bible. Because this is the original Bible, the translation of King James. You have the modern translation of King James.
Uh-huh.
You have to get the original, which contains all of the books.
You see, I even want some better Bible, but they have only specific Bible they want us to have.
You have to go on Amazon, because it's hard to find these Bibles. You have to go on the internet. It's called 1611 King James Bible. 1611.
That's
King
the
James
first
Bible.
Edition.
That's the first Bible that King James translated.
Wow.
So, like I was telling you, everything has a cycle. Like the rain has a cycle, and the wind has a cycle, and the water has a cycle. Spirits have cycles.
That means the placement was my feeling.
Spirit.
It was temporarily there, and it would be back on the
earth at a later time, usually 3 generations, and then you would be born on the earth again and live out your life again until the day of judgment at the end. See, we do this cycle until the day of judgment. When the day of judgment comes, then those that are reserved, the elect, will be saved from the judgment that comes on the earth. That's what it means, that they're held in judgment to that time. So you're this is not the first time that we come on the earth.
So my spirit wouldn't be there forever waiting for tribulation.
No.
But he would now come back.
It would come back. The place of judgment, give me Ecclesiastes. I'm going to show you where the place of judgment is. Like when you do sin, you know, like you sin and then you go to God to get judged. I'm going to show you where you play out your judgment, where you have to endure your judgment. Give me the book of Ecclesiastes.
God already told me he restored me, and he knows my sins, but he forgives me.
Ecclesiastes, chapter...
Ecclesiastes 6 and 10. Say not thou, what is the cause of it? Ecclesiastes 6 and 10. That which have been is named already, and it is known that it is man. Neither may he contend with him that is mightier than
he. So man has been on the earth before. Now, go to Ecclesiastes chapter 3. Start at verse 14.
Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 14.
Remember, God makes everything in the, remember he said, as a ring, or as a cycle for eternity.
Uh-huh.
Now read that.
I know that whatsoever God doeth, it shall be forever.
Remember, he said his judgment as a ring, a circle which represents eternity, or forever. You read that again.
I know that whatsoever God doeth, it shall be forever.
Recall the scripture, because I think it's kind of like that.
Ecclesiastes 3 and 14.
All the way
chapter,
to 16.
Chapter 3, verse 14.
To 16.
I know that whatsoever God doeth, it shall be forever. Nothing can be put to it, nor anything taken from it. But God doeth it, that men should fear before him. That which hath been is now, and that which is to be hath already been. And God,
then if that which is to be hath already been, there's children that are going to be born. They're in the womb. They're not yet, but they're going to be born. Meaning that they have been here before. That which, read that again.
That which hath been is now, and that which is to be have already been.
The things that have is to be, or the people that are to be, have already been. Keep going.
And God required that which is past.
God required that which is past. And the things you've done in your past life, he requires it. You have to pay the judgment for it. Right here.
What is the name?
Ecclesiastes. It's in Old English.
I know.
Yeah, Ecclesiastes.
I will not be able to read it.
Yeah,
no, you can
read it.
Read it,
you'll learn. He couldn't read it before either. But when you read it so much, you'll just start to understand and learn.
I probably will not be able to.
You'll be able to. Well, go ahead.
And moreover, I saw under the sun the place of judgment.
Wait, read that again.
And moreover, I saw under the sun the place of judgment.
The place of judgment is under the sun. We're under the sun, right?
Uh-huh.
This is the place of judgment. So all the things that we did in our past life and we have to be punished for, we get punished on the earth. That's why some people are born with disease, sickness, yes.
God punishes them.
God punishes them on the earth.
God punishes. You see, when I cry and pray, I ask God, vindicate me, avenge me. Don't let them be happy from and blowing this manner from my sorrow. Don't let them give me from my pain.
But you're here.
And he didn't like it. He said, I have already my punishment.
But you're on the earth and you're living out your judgment from your past life. Your past life. So we're on the earth, we're living out our judgment. Like, for the bad things we did in our past life, we're paying for it now. Understand? That's how God's, his wing or his judgment works. Spirits have to be recycled. See, this right here is the S. That's how they wrote S in the Old English. It looks like the F, but it's an S. It's just small things. Oh, it's a small? Yeah, it's small. They don't make it any bigger. Because it's actually a photocopy of the King James, the Bible that King James translated. So it doesn't change yet. They have it on the internet.
You see, there is so many things taken from the Bible that we don't teach.
Mm-hmm.
They don't want people to be blessed. They to have to know things right.
Right. But that's why we That's why God raised us up to come out here and teach the word. Because we have to teach the truth. Like I had to show you about the ring and about your spirit. When you die, go to the chamber of the souls, and then it comes back down to the earth. And then when you die again, it goes to the chamber of the souls, and then it comes back down to the earth during the circle. You got it? Circle.
This is the bigger one. It doesn't have an actual...
Oh, yeah, they do have that. It's a bigger one.
Tobit.
Oh, this is not in our Bible.
Tobit. Right, this is the Apocrypha. This has
1611.
A regular ones in there too.
That's
there
the books that's missing out of the your Bible.
Yeah.
You have to get those books, huh?
So this one is made.
Bible. King James Version of the Apocrypha. You just gotta get the Oxford World.
Oxford World Classic.
Here's a little bigger. But it's not gonna have the actual ones like the spelling how it was.
That's right, yeah, that's the only, I think that's why one of the only ones you get like that.
Yeah, this has the regular
one. Oxford World Classics.
King James Apocrypha.
King James Bible. 1611. 1611. With Apocrypha. A-P-O-C-R-Y-P-H-A. C-R-Y.
Apocrypha.
Yesterday in book for Barnes and Nobles, and I looked for the Bible.
It's not in there.
But there are weak Bibles, new Bibles, one.
New King James, like the new, I mean new NIV?
Yeah.
There's a lot of those in there. Those are not good Bibles. It's not good ones.
They change the words. You have to get that Bible, but you have to go online and buy it. You're not going to find it in the stores.
That is problem because I don't.
Do
banking
don't
by
go
computer.
Internet?
No, I don't do computer banking.
Oh, you don't buy on the computer?
Yeah.
Can you get somebody to buy for you? Like, can you get somebody to buy for you? Do you know anybody that can buy for you?
Do you think Burns and Noble can order it for me?
Oh, yes, probably.
Probably they can order it.
Yeah. Tell them that's the one you want, they can order it for you.
Tell them, give them the money, I guess, and then they'll bring it in, and you pick it up.
But, you see, in Jerusalem. So, is it what supposed to happen?
What is what?
That promise collect back Jew, call back Jew to Israel.
That's what's happening now. That's why we out here. Because Holy Son of the slave. See these people?
Wow!
I know. Ooh. See these people?
Uh-huh.
This man isn't treated like this anymore. So God, give me Zephaniah chapter 2, verse 1. So God has told us to go out to gather these people, tell them that he has come to save them, that he's going to save them from this, and that we're going to go back to Israel, and that we're going to rule the whole world, and we're going to teach all the nations the laws of God and how to worship him. That's why we're here. So
but,
that is going to happen.
But you see, Jerusalem is too small.
It's going to be bigger. It's going to be bigger. The land is going to get bigger. That's a whole other conversation. Plus, the nation of Israel, the whole 12 tribes of Israel, they're going to rule the whole earth, and they're going to rule inside of other nations. Yes? You got it?
Wow!
Yeah.
Here we go. So cool to know it.
2-1, right?
Yeah.
It's Zephaniah. Chapter 2, verse 1. Gather yourselves together
Yea, gather together, O nation not desired.
This is the nation not desired. Nobody in America desires these people. These people are not desired by America. These are the undesirables of America. These are the people that live in the little huddled together in hoods. Like you went to Atlanta and you seen them sitting on the hard seats. These are the people that's not desired in America. But listen what God says. Go ahead.
Before the decree.
Read it again.
Gather yourselves together. Yea, gather together, O nation not desired. Before the decree bring forth, before the day pass as the chaff.
Before the decree, which is the destruction. Go ahead.
Before the fierce anger of the Lord come upon you.
Right.
Before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you.
Right.
Seek ye the Lord.
Seek ye the Lord. Go ahead.
All ye meek of the earth.
That's why we come out. Go ahead.
Which have wrought his judgment. Seek righteousness. Seek meekness. It may be ye shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger.
Read that again. You shall be what?
Ye shall be dead in the day of the Lord's anger.
So we got to go out and we got to gather these people, the nation that's not desired, back to God. So we can tell them how to get saved. So that when the day of destruction comes, the ones of them that believe, they'll be saved. Go ahead.
For God they shall be forsaken, and Ashkelon a desolation. They shall drive out Ashdod.
That's it. That's it on Ashdod. So we have to go save these people.
How about Europe?
Europe?
There is no Europe.
Because Europe, the Europeans are not Israelites. These are just the 12 tribes of Israel.
Uh-huh.
These are the sons, see? These are the sons of Israel. Judah, Benjamin, yeah. Levi, Sip. Now these are what they're called today.
Uh-huh.
See, Judah are the Negroes. These Negroes, these
yeah.
are Judah. This is the tribe of Judah.
Wow.
You see, I told you my dad was Jamaican.
Mm-hmm.
So me, I would be the West Indies,
mm-hmm.
would be Benjamin, the tribe of Benjamin. The tribe of Levi would be the people that live in Haiti. They call them Haitians today. You see, you understand?
Yeah.
So that's what this sign means. These are the people that we have to go gather.
Yeah.
Then after, okay, hold on.
But there is a line.
Mm-hmm. Because they call us by a lot of names.
Right.
Go ahead, I'll read
it. It's Revelation 5 verse 9, chapter 5 verse 9. And they sung a new song saying, Thou art worthy to take the book and to open the seals thereof, for thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to God by thy blood out of every kindred and tongue and people and nation.
Because these people, Israel, Negroes, and Native Americans are scattered all over the earth. Like when they took us and they put us in slavery, the slave ship didn't just come to America. They came to America, they came to the West Indies, they went to Europe, they went to South Africa, they went to North Africa, they went to Russia, they went to everywhere. So these people are scattered everywhere. So God is going to save them out of every nation. He's going to save these people out of every nation. He's going to take them from every nation. Go ahead.
And has made us unto our God kings and priests.
And now we're kings, like we're the bottom. We're in the world, these people, the people that came to America and every other Western slave ships, in the social order, they're the lowest. But now our God is going to make us the highest. It said the first shall be last and the last shall be first. These people, which are the low in America, the bottom of the economics ladder in America, are going to be on the top.
But look at
in
that
Jerusalem.
Way. Look at that way.
Mm-hmm.
Puerto Rican, you know how many is Puerto Rican, but they not all are Jewish.
Most of them are.
Most of them are.
You have, see what happened is, during colonialism, the times of colonialism, when so-called Europeans came to America, and they went to certain parts of Africa and they brought slaves here, they mixed with the people. Now your father, whatever your father is, you are. So if your father is an Israelite, you're an Israelite. So when they mixed together, they mixed up the seed with the children of Israel. So not all of them are. Not all Puerto Ricans are Israelites. Some of them are conquistadors.
Wait a minute. King David was Judah or Israel? Judah.
But Judah, Israel.
Because King David's son is also Jacob. Generation of King David, Jacob, and Israel.
No, Jacob. Jacob will be the great-great-great-great-great-great-grandfather of King David.
Yeah!
Right. So, Judah, see, Israel, tribes of Israel. Tribes of Israel, take tribes off, and look, that sons
King
of
David,
Israel.
King David is father of all of them.
No.
No direct father, great-great-great-great-great-great.
No.
Jacob.
Jacob, but yes. Jacob's father, Jacob is line of David.
Jacob is
line of
David is line of Jacob. David comes from Jacob.
You see, now I made misunderstood.
Okay.
That means all of this are generation of King David.
Of Jacob.
Jacob.
King. Is Jacob?
Jacob King. First, yeah. King David second.
Aha!
See?
Jacob, yes. Jacob is generation
Abraham.
Uh-huh.
Isaac.
Uh-huh. Jacob.
Jacob. Then the 12 sons, Judah.
Uh-huh.
Judah.
Yeah.
And then King David. You see?
Judah was, King David was in Judah.
King David comes from Judah.
Right.
Judah was a man. Judah was a man.
Yeah.
And King David comes from Judah.
Right.
He's a son, one of the sons of the lineage of Judah.
Uh-huh.
And Solomon, he came through Judah.
King David's generation is supposed to rule forever.
Right.
King David's generation supposed to rule forever.
That's who Jesus Christ came through.
Yeah.
Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Judah, David. It said that Jesus, I'm just using that name. That's not his name, but I'm just using it.
Yeshua?
30 minutes.
Yes. Yes. He was supposed to sit on the throne of David to rule forever.
Uh-huh.
So when it says that David line will rule forever, it's because Jesus is the ruler forever. He's the ruler over the whole nation of Israel forever. So that's what it means. That's what it means.
Because
that
promise
King
David always will have forever.
Yep. But that's why Jesus Christ came through the line of David. Romans. I'm gonna show you in the book of Romans. Romans chapter 1, verse 3.
It's Romans 1 and 3. Concerning his son, Jesus Christ our Lord, which is made of the seed of David, according to the flesh.
Man, the seed means like, seed is like semen, sperm, or, children. Read it again.
Concerning his son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, which is made of the seed of David.
Man, he comes through the line, or so do you speak, so the sperm of David.
According to the flesh.
According to the flesh, meaning as concerning his flesh. Not his spirit, but as concerning his flesh, he came through the lineage of David.
Yeah.
So David's lineage was supposed to rule forever, right?
Yeah.
Well, that's why Jesus Christ came through David's lineage.
Uh-huh.
Because David was supposed to rule forever, his king and his son.
Yeah.
So Jesus Christ is the ruler forever. So that's why he came through the line of King David.
So, who will rule from Jerusalem?
Who will rule from Jerusalem?
Uh-huh.
It will be
Someone from themselves.
It will be Israel, but over Israel, it's gonna be, we'll just say Jesus Christ. He'll be over Jesus. It's the order. Jesus Christ, and then the 12 tribes of Israel.
That is in the when the new government will be from Jerusalem.
Uh-huh.
So from Jerusalem will be rule over Europe too.
Over the whole earth. Israel is gonna rule over the whole earth. Just like America rules the whole earth and Rome rules the whole earth, Jerusalem will rule the whole earth. And they're gonna do it in righteousness. They're gonna make the earth righteous.
But you see, when they will discard the three, Satan, Lucifer, and Beelzebub, when they will be discarded?
They'll never be discarded. They're just gonna have to follow the orders of God and the children of Israel. What is it?
Those
states shall rule the world.
3666.
Is that Corinthians?
3:16.
I think so.
3:16.
Yeah.
Do you know the judge is? A judge is an authority. In Hebrew, it's Allah. Or some might say El. It means power or an authority. Uh-huh. Like a king.
Elohim.
Right. Or like Elohim. Elohim. Or we say Allahim.
Uh-huh.
Which means that's plural. Like judges.
Uh-huh.
But the singular version of it is El or Allah.
Uh-huh.
Which means authority or power. So we're going to be authorities. Israel is going to be authorities over the whole world. They're going to be the judges and kings of the whole world. Go ahead, read that.
I don't see how it will happen having churches that worship Jesus.
Because these churches are not authorized by God.
But they will never become...
They're going to be thrown down.
They're going to be thrown down.
They're supposed to, but... I was asking when will those three, Satan, Lucifer, and Beelzebub, will be thrown down?
Oh, you mean as concerning these churches?
Because
they're going to be thrown down.
There is evil that God did. Evil makes them mislead. Evil misleads all world.
It's because of the people that rule the earth.
Yeah.
See, the angels in heaven, they have to listen to God. You remember the book of Job?
Mm-hmm.
God said what to Satan? He said, you can only do this, this, and this to him, but you cannot kill him.
Mm-hmm.
Now, did the devil ever kill Job?
No.
Because God told him he couldn't. So that means what? He has to listen to God. He cannot overstep his boundaries. He cannot go over what God says. He has to do what God says.
That means they get understanding. Maybe they get understanding and pay for them. No, we're not supposed to pay for them.
The churches?
We can teach them and they have to make their own decision.
The churches?
Those who worship Jesus like a God.
No. You know what? You know what it is? Like it said in Revelation 13, these people have committed blasphemy against the Most High God, His Son, and the angels, and the people of the saints. So you know what that means? These people have to be judged for what they did. All of this stuff, these churches, is going to be cast down. It's going to be burnt up. When the Most High destroys this place and all the kingdoms in the world and brings in His kingdom, these people are not going to rule anymore. The rulers of the new earth are going to be the saints of the Most High, which are the children of Israel.
But it's supposed to happen soon because it's already 6,000 years.
It's going
to
happen soon, yes. That, you know what? The sign that it's going to happen soon is us out here. Yeah, Jesus Christ said what? He said these people ask for a sign, but they shall get the sign of, what was it? The sign of Jonah.
Uh-huh.
What was Jonah? He was a prophet. Prophet sign. So just the fact that you see us out here on the corners is the sign to show you that this kingdom and the wickedness of this world is going to be destroyed soon.
Look at this picture. Mm-hmm. It was made when I was preaching in Salt Lake City, Utah. There are Mormons.
Mm-hmm.
And
I
look,
know about that.
Here is Catholic Community Services building,
mm-hmm.
covered with white cloud and red. White cloud, the white color symbolizes purity and innocence. Red, love and blood. And Roman,
that's crimson.
Roman Catholic, Roman crucify Messiah,
mm-hmm.
and cover him with his blood.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we know it's blood on the sky.
Red, that's crimson. That also represents wickedness. Crimson also represents wickedness.
This?
No. This red.
Red color wickedness?
Crimson. That's what crimson is, a derivative of red.
Because you see, wickedness and on the Jesus, Messiah, Yeshua. They, Roman, who create Catholic religion, Roman Catholic Church, you know? Rome, above Roman, because they crucified him, they maltreated him. And he was covered with his blood. Maltreated him also means red color, so it, we see sign before tribulation, red blood on the sky, because if we take, we can find out that it is blood on the sky.
Where'd you take that with?
Utah.
You have a camera?
It was a camera, my camera. I stand
across...
A picture across,
phone camera?
Yeah, no, one-time use camera.
Oh, okay.
I stand and I was... scared. I was like, this red color looks like blood.
Mm.
And I saw God push the white cloud, and I saw it was coming fast.
Mm.
And stop.
Mm.
And it didn't move far. And I was asking, God, what I see, give me understanding. This cloud is not moving far. It stands exactly above the Catholic, Roman Catholic community. Services. And understanding came to me, book of Acts, chapter 2, Acts, chapter 2, verse 17 to 22, sign of the sky, before tribulation, book of Acts, chapter 2, verse 17, has the sign before tribulation, all of them already came out.
No, not yet, that sign is talking about. Do you know what the tribute? Do you know what the tribulation is? Do you know what the tribulation is talking about?
I know.
About?
Tribulation is one main judgment of God for all mankind.
You know what that judgment is going to be?
It will be soon, because we already are in the end of the 6,000 years.
Do you know what it is going to be?
When?
What? What?
How it will look?
No, what it is. What it is going to, what's going to cause it?
Those souls who choose God in their life.
No, I mean like.
They will be in paradise.
Like
paradise.
This.
I know that there is paradise for people. There will be no more
earthly
government.
Like this. The first judgment was what? When God destroyed the earth by what? Water, right? It flooded the whole earth.
Okay.
That's what I mean. Do you know what the second judgment or tribulation is going to be caused by?
Probably by fire, but we are not dead.
Yes, the Bible says fire. It says it in 1 Peter. It said that he was going to destroy the earth by fire, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. Give me Zechariah this one. I'm going to show you what the tribulation is going to come by.
For tribulation, blood on the sky, and we know it because innocent covered with blood about Roman Catholic Church.
This is where the tribulation is going to come by. This is the second, this is the what the judgment of God is going to be.
we on all America have and the rest
die.
Of the nation.
We all have to die. We, but on the tribulation...
What verse 5 says? That's 12? That's the last, give me the last chapter.
After this tribulation, there will be no more earthly government.
It is going to be an earthly government. Remember, I just read it in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 2.
It must happen before tribulation.
What? What must happen before tribulation? The earthly government?
Yeah.
No, it happens, well, yeah, in a way, because you're looking at, Lord willing, we be part of the elect. You're looking at a part of the government to come. The prophets are going to be the government to come.
I don't know, I forgot that thing that God told me, because, but he said that
well, he tells you in
that
the Bible.
Earth will be reshaped. Face of the earth will be reshaped.
Zechariah, man.
What you looking for, ma?
Yeah, I'm looking for Zechariah. Hold on. Zechariah 14:4. DJ.
Zechariah 14:4. And this shall be the plague where the Lord will smite all the people that have fought against Jerusalem. Their flesh shall consume away while they stand upon their feet, and their eyes shall consume away in their holes, and their tongue shall consume away in their mouth. And it shall come to pass in that day that a great tumult from the Lord shall be among them.
What's that?
Verse 12. And this shall be the plague where the Lord will smite all the people that have fought against Jerusalem. Their flesh shall consume away while they stand upon their feet, and their eyes shall consume away in their holes, and their tongue shall consume away in their mouth.
Now how can your flesh consume away while you're standing on your feet, and your eyes consume away while you're still standing on your feet, and your tongue? The only thing that can cause that is thermonuclear fire, to where your body disintegrates before you hit the ground, like Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Now this, in 1 Peter, it said that the earth was not the earth, it said that this next judgment is going to be coming by fire. This next judgment is going to come by a world war that's going to lead to a great fire, thermonuclear warfare.
So after that, earth will be reshaped.
After this, earth will be reshaped. Yes.
In other words, re-governed.
That's beautiful. Revelation chapter 21. Shall be a new earth and new heaven.
Oh yeah.
That's beautiful. I pray
that verse
now. Revelation chapter 21, verse start of verse 1.
Revelation chapter 21, verse 1. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away.
That means really this is talking about the new earth meaning the earth. And the new heavens meaning the root. This heaven is talking about the rulership of the earth. So there's going to be a new rulership, which I told you was going to be the children of Israel, ruling the whole world in righteousness. It's really going to be the main rulers are going to be the prophets, the elect. And then,
so why God told me after tribulation, those who choose, those who repent, they will have eternal life in paradise.
The paradise is going to be on the earth. Keep reading. Paradise is going to be on earth.
You think the earth
is
going to be
destroyed? I'm sorry, go ahead. You want to speak?
You think the earth is going to be destroyed?
He said that the earth will be reshaped.
But you know how somebody says, man, you look like you're in bad shape.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean that your body is like, it just changed. It means like the state of your mind. Like you're probably going through a lot of stress. And that's what he's reading. Like the earth is going to be reshaped, meaning regoverned. So there's going to be, like when it says a new earth, a new heaven has came down, everything is going to be reordered. There's not going to be any more wickedness. The Israelites are going to rule, and they're going to basically police or govern the whole earth. So that's how it's going to be reshaped.
And the earth is going to have to be, because the earth is polluted.
It's polluted, yeah, that's
so
another
thing. It's going to have to be clean. Angels are going to have to come down and clean the whole earth. Some of the earth is going to get bigger. Things like that. Yes, the earth is going to be totally redone.
Everything.
Everything. As if it was new. That's what we mean.
The earth and the people, everything.
Keep reading.
Yeah.
Look, keep reading. What, listen,
and the
listen.
Darkness is for those who disobey God.
Listen, watch this. Go ahead, keep reading.
And I, John, a new heaven, the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea.
This is the first earth and the first heaven. This is going to be done away with. All it, like the churches and the wickedness and the polluted land, the polluted water, it's all going to be done away with. There's going to be a new heaven and a new earth. The earth's going to be clean. The rulers on the earth are going to be clean and righteousness and ruling all the earth.
But it's supposed to be paradise.
It is. Would it not be paradise if everything was righteous? If you could walk down the street and you could just pull an apple off the tree and it's a nice clean apple, it's not a genetically modified apple, is that not paradise? It's paradise. Not only that, it said the Spirit of God shall dwell with man. All of this is going to be on earth. The earth was made for us to live on. This spirit that the Most High God put into bodies to live on the earth. Earth is paradise. It's not a paradise now because it's ruled by wickedness.
I read this?
Go ahead.
Precept Proverbs 29:2. Going with the brother just said, it says, when the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice.
Right.
But when the wicked bear rule, the people mourn.
Can you get the word paradise for me?
Yeah.
Look it up in the etymology. And if you can, the dictionary, either one.
I got it right here.
The earth is a paradise. Remember the Garden of Eden? Mm-hmm. It was very beautiful.
Yeah.
That was paradise.
Yeah.
That matter of fact, if I'm not mistaken, that's where the word paradise comes from. We're going to get it, though.
Paradise, right?
Yeah, you got it?
And they were talking about the whole earth. In the Garden of Eden, it was the whole earth. It wasn't just one section of the planet. It was the whole earth they were talking about.
All right, go ahead. Read that.
Okay, this is Genesis 1:8. And the Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had formed. Eden.
Got it. See the word? He's gonna tell you what the word paradise is.
Paradise. Late 12th century. Meaning Garden of Eden. From Old French, paradise. Paradise. Garden of Eden. From late Latin paradisus, from Greek paradisios, part paradise, Garden of Eden. From my Iranian source, paradesa, enclosure, part Persian and Arabic furdis, garden, paradise.
So the word paradise, when you go back to the Persian, well, did it say Persian, right?
Mm-hmm.
When you go back to the original languages, like Persian, it means garden.
Yeah.
So paradise actually means like the Garden of Eden. Now, when you go into the book of Isaiah and Jeremiah, it said that Jerusalem particularly was going to be as the Garden of Eden. So the earth is going to be the paradise. When it says paradise, when you hear like you're going to be in paradise, it's talking about the earth. Like when
So will it be time that there will be no place for people?
No, people are going to live on the earth.
No, because it will be prepared, so it takes a time.
No, it won't. They can do it in an instant. It's the Most High is powerful. There's nothing impossible. You read this in, I think, Matthew. There's nothing impossible for God.
That right.
Means,
it can go fast. It will not take, like, years.
No.
It doesn't happen. I mean, we don't know for sure, but it doesn't happen. You can do it just like this. They said in the twinkling of an eye
right.
That our bodies would go.